These are the 1, 4, and 5 chord exercises, teaching inversions also while you're learning the 1, 4, and 5. Let's start with C. If you're in the key of C, as when you play the C scale, if you're a piano player, you might think of it as the scale of C. If you play other instruments as well, you know this is just called the key of C. So C chord is the number one chord because number one means the name of the scale that you're in. So there's a C chord. Now number four means the fourth note in that scale. So count 1, 2, 3, 4. Number four is F. So the F chord is the fourth chord. And the fifth note is the fifth chord, G. But instead of moving your hand all the way up there and all the way up there, let's learn to invert them from a pattern exercise that you can do on every scale, on every key. C chord, to begin with, is root position. Move up to F. Just these two notes came up. Did you see that? I kept the C, but I moved these two fingers up. And that became an inverted F chord. Now if I move all my fingers up one, it's a G chord. It's the number five chord. There's number five. Let's do that one more time. One, number one. Move just these two notes up for number four. Move all the fingers up, and you're on number five chord, inverted. It's a G, it's just inverted. Let's do one more for the sake of the exercise, which is move up to a C chord that's inverted. Instead of going back to the C chord on root position, we're gonna take where we're at and just move up by keeping that note in the middle, but moving this note up and this note up brings us to C chord again, but it's inverted. So it sounds like this. 1, 4, 5, 1. The same pattern that I described, which fingers to move, which notes to move, will be applied to every key that you're in to find your 1, 4, and 5. Get used to it so that you don't have to think of the name or the number when you're playing. You just know you need the 1, the 4, and the 5. So you know you're going to need, if you're in a song that's playing in the key of C, you know you're going to need this chord and this chord and this chord and the C again. Let's show the same pattern in another chord. Let's move down to G. Let's play root position G. Now when you're in the key of G, you know you need the number 1 chord and the number 4 chord, which is going to be C, 1, 2, 3, 4. Aha, now I'm on the C chord. I'm inverted. I also know I need that 5th chord. Here's the 5th note. So when I go up to the D chord, I'm going to move all my fingers in order to reach this position, the D chord, D, F sharp, A. And one more position, keeping the same note here though, but keep moving the other two up, brings me to where I started, which is G. However, now I'm in an inverted G instead of the root G. So we start on the root, we go up to the 4th chord, up to the 5th chord, and back to the 1st chord, number 1 chord here, but inverted. It's a great exercise. Do this with as many keys as you know how to play in. You can do D probably. D, the 4th note is G chord. The 5th note is going to be A chord. And then I'm going to return the sound to where I started, which is D, but I'm going to be inverted. All right, and for the sake of this exercise, pay attention to your fingers and do what's comfortable. Don't do something that is not comfortable, because you want to start teaching your hands to memorize the shape and the feel so that you can go and just be right there and be ready when you come to it, all right?